Okay, it's 7:35, and this is a ZBA hearing. The applicant is Stephen By, and he's looking for a variance on a minimum yard dimension of 42 feet at 12 Stockwell Road. Who's going to speak to that?
Steve Silverman, president of Valley Home Improvement, the contractor. Steve and Heidi have hired. Should I just run down the...
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. So, Stephen and Heidi By of 12 Stockwell Road. Property owners are the same. This is for a variance. Section 4.1, particularly the front setback. The property is located on the south side of Stockwell. Map number 68, parcel 65, and the zoning district is AR. The proposed project is a front and side addition. There's no change to the use of the property. It's a single-family residence.
The current setback is 54 feet now?
Correct. Correct. And I left two documents with you. The one is a certified plot plan done by Eaton & Associates, showing in black the proposed side and rear, side and front additions, and then the proposed setback. Also on that large-scale print are two neighborhood properties. Just to show you that there are some examples on that, on Stockwell Road already, that currently encroach on the 50-foot setback. And so we're proposing that our addition has no substantial effect on the character of the neighborhood. And on the second page of the prints, current photos of the house and the proposed two-story addition, which we hope you'll find as an improvement.
What's the increase square footage?
I think it's somewhere around 900 square feet or so.
Over two floors.
No.
About 450 or 460 per floor.
Would you like me to go into some of the reasons why we'd like you to find a favorable ruling?
Sure.
Okay. So the way the house is situated as a keep, the living room is in the front quarter, and we're anticipating that the Bys growing their family, and living space is why we're here. And in order not to reconfigure the entire house, the addition, we feel, would work best off the front and side. Also, we have a septic tank considerations in the back, and that puts a real financial hardship on Heidi and Steve to consider a rear addition.
Plus the hatchway is in the rear too, so we're only planning on doing a crawl space basement with this addition, and if we had to move the hatchway, then we'd have to do a full basement to reposition it somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
The two main goals of what we're trying to do is to increase our family room and to add a third bedroom upstairs, so this accomplishes both of those. And by going forward, we're going forward about 10 to 12 feet from the current property. Gives us the bigger living room and then allows us to put the bedroom front and aft on the second floor.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions? Is there anybody in the audience that wishes to speak to this?
I'm Tom Harris. I own adjacent property.
Yeah.
And I hadn't seen this before tonight, but I don't see any problem with this at all.
Okay. Chris.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, make a, make.
Looks good.
Make a motion that, to grant the, variance to reduce the setback from 50 to 42 feet in accordance with the plan that was submitted.
Yeah.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Thank you.
Thank you.
Can I take one more minute and ask a question?
Go ahead.
The process is, will this now be sent over to Tim's office? And is there any type of waiting period? Where, I guess we're feeling like we're under the clock.
There's technically, the way it works is that the written opinion will be given to the town clerk. There's actually a 20-day waiting period for that. Now, certainly some people have asked to start within that 20 days. It is up to you guys to make that decision. If somebody appeals it, then you're into that issue. But it's one of those decisions you have to make.
Yeah.
But there is a 20-day appeal period. Unfortunately, if somebody wants to appeal it, they usually wait till the last day to appeal it for you. And as soon as that appeal period is over, then we can grant any and all permits relative to.
Thank you.
Right,
thank
you.
For your time.
Yeah,
thank you very much.
Thank you for the seats.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sign up sheet for.
Yes.
I guess. Thank you.
John, I'm going to try to put another row in here. Can we push these things back slightly?
Yeah.
And we'll try to put another row in.
Yeah,
you can.
Okay, this 7:45, and this is a continuation a request by Joel Greenbaum for variance to add more residential units than allowed by zoning bylaws, specifically to North Hadley Hall, 239 River Drive, map 60, lot 29. Who's speaking to this today? You can sit right down in front there, or you can stand. You can stand if you want.
I'll sit. I can be sat if there are any. A site plan, a floor plan, a drawing, a render. And some photos of recent projects we've done.
Would this require a elevator?
No. So I can introduce myself if you'd like.
Go ahead.
So, my name is Joel Greenbaum, and
excuse me, Mr. Greenbaum, could you speak up a little bit?
Sure.
I don't think that
Hello?
I think that's on.
No.
Maybe if you face that.
Yeah.
Sure. So, my name is Joel Greenbaum, and I'm interested in purchasing North Hadley Hall and restoring it and converting it to 10 apartments, which will consist of 6 studios and 4 one-bedroom apartments. Cosmetically, aesthetically, the building would pretty much look the same. I mean, it would have a new roof and new windows and new painting. All the black top that's in front of the fire station would be removed and turned to open space, flowers, grass, trees, and the parking would be moved to the north. We would be introducing some windows to the rear and a couple on the south, on the fire station side, first floor. Otherwise, the building would look exactly as it looks today, but cleaned up. And quite attractive, I believe. I think that the 10 apartments may sound intimidating, but it's going to be people living by themselves, studios and one bedrooms. I think it'll be quiet. I know it'll be quiet. We have 8 across the street at 240 River Drive, and that building has been very quiet.
How close do you live to consider it quiet?
Well, I lived in North Hadley for 17 years.
But now?
Now I live in Amherst.
Okay.
But if it wasn't quiet, I would hear about it. It's a building that won't be lived in by undergrads. Undergrads don't care for North Hadley because there's no bus. It'll be lived in by young professional people like we have across the street. They like North Hadley. It's quiet. It's central to everything. They don't need a bus.
How can you guarantee that?
Excuse me. We'll let him make his presentation. The board will ask some questions, then we'll open it up to anybody that wants to speak, all right? Thank you.
I'm not going to sit here and guarantee anything, but I can just show you from experience, our personal experience and personal history, that it would be quiet. I mean, right across the street, 240 River Drive, has 6 one-bedrooms and 2 two-bedrooms. They're all lived in by adults, professors, grad students, teachers. It would be exactly the same. That's pretty much it in a nutshell, I think. I think it would be nice to preserve the building. It's a beautiful building. It's kind of the anchor of North Hadley Village. It would be very pretty when it's finished. It would be nice to have it back on the Hadley tax rolls, I believe. I think that's it.
I noticed on your plot plan here. You've got parking spaces for 15. Do you really think that's going to be adequate?
It may not be adequate. I'd prefer to make it 20. I think 15 would be more than adequate, but just to be safe.
Well, in my observation opinion, I would think that each apartment will end up being two people. And everybody has their own car nowadays.
Yes, I agree.
Especially if they're not on the bus route like you mentioned.
I think that there will most likely be couples that live in the one bedrooms, but the studios will probably be lived in by one person. They're not very big, they're about the size of this room.
There are four apartments there now.
Pardon?
There are four apartments there now.
There's no apartments.
There's no apartments.
Okay. And you're proposing?
Ten.
So there would be four in the firehouse, four studios, and then three on each floor of the main building.
How many apartments is there in the, you said there's eight across the street?
Correct.
And do you know how many parking spaces you have for that?
I haven't counted, but I'm guessing around 12.
And then how many apartments are there in the house next to the lake?
One.
One.
Just one.
Just one. Any questions?
Tim, do you know if the house across the street, is that from a variance or is that just grandfathered?
No, it's grandfathered. That goes back prior to zone.
Are there any other properties that have been that have gotten variances for apartment uses?
The last one was on Middle Street, the nursing home.
May I add to this lady's question? So, if I was up here proposing four apartments, four bedrooms, or four three-bedrooms, mm-hmm. then I would be worried if I were you. But single-bedroom apartments are quiet. So I do, you know, I understand your concern.
Yeah.
It would be my concern as well.
Sure. Being a young family and just moving to North Hadley 5 years ago, you know, it's our little village.
Of course.
We care about quietness. We care about apartments going up, college students, who exactly would be living there. Are my children safe? We're all aware of what's going on in the town over the last week or so. And that's why I'm here, sort of advocating for families that want to move to Hadley because it's a wonderful, safe place to raise a family.
Yeah.
And the fact that apartments might be going up next to us, you know, worries me.
Sure. Well, I share that concern because I love North Hadley too.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
And I have a stake in North Hadley. But I also love this building. But I assure you that I wouldn't do anything to bring that type of behavior into North Hadley.
I guess the problem is it's not a guarantee.
Nothing
like
in life is a guarantee, but like I'm telling you before, if I was putting in four large apartments where
mm-hmm.
people would live in
and
packs and numbers,
mm-hmm.
I would be worried.
Yep.
But when people tend to live like by themselves, or even a couple,
yep.
it's pretty quiet. And it's just like across the street. I use that as an example because they're like kind. I mean, they're nearly the same.
Mm-hmm.
But I understand.
You did mention how it's sort of the anchor of our little community
there.
It is,
yeah.
And I agree with you,
mm-hmm.
and I've only lived there for a short period of time, and I think a lot of us would like to keep it as an anchor. And I think when we think of something like that, we think of something maybe we could all share as a community, not necessarily apartments.
Sure.
And
well,
I have no doubt that you'll beautify the land, and it probably
yeah.
will, and the restoration of the whole, of the building. I love love that idea.
Yeah, well, let me answer to that too, because when I first of all, I've loved that building since I was a kid. It's a beautiful, beautiful building. So when the whole RFP originally came up, you know, I thought long and hard, well, what can this building be used best for the community, okay? So I thought, okay, how about first floor retail stores? That might be nice. You know, there's no retail in North Hadley. It might bring some life into the village. How about turning the first floor of the fire station into a coffee shop? You know, you could have a big, nice coffee shop with a back deck looking over the lake. You could have seating in the front. I mean, I had a lot of ideas. And a lot of these ideas came from the architecture in South Hadley. You know, the stores right in the, I forget what it's called. But it could be made very much like that. But I don't know the commercial business that well. I've also been told from the residents of North Hadley they don't want that type of traffic. And so I proposed what I know, and that's residential. So.
You mentioned that the blacktop in the front of the building would be taken up and that would be open space or lawn or something.
That's correct. I have some drawings here which I can pass around.
I was wondering about the space between the building and the church. Would that all be taken up in parking spaces, or would there be any space left for access
the
to
parking,
the church or the pond?
So this does not represent the whole field, and I'm sorry about that, but if this is the building, this would be the parking, which extends approximately 70 feet. So there would still be quite a large amount of open grass space, but I'm sorry, I don't have the whole.
What do you propose to do with that?
Just leave
space?
It as is.
Who hasn't signed?
Did you get a hand?
I think
they
got it.
Yeah, Simon. Linda, do you have any more questions?
No,
right. All right. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I was wondering how. you understand how this would impact the field to the left of this building? Mm-hmm. I know the picture doesn't extend that
it doesn't, I'm
far
sorry,
north,
yeah.
But what's your understanding of the impact there?
I'm very sensitive to the field, and that's
yeah.
why, I mean, originally I was interested in working with the town to putting the fire station there, but I found it inappropriate. I don't believe it belongs there. I think that North Hadley Village Hall should keep the land that it came with. So yes, it is a little unfortunate the parking will take some of that space, but I mean, it's a trade-off. It's gonna make the whole front of the building look a lot more attractive. I wish that I did have a larger plot plan, but the 70 feet doesn't take that much of the field.
Was the 70 feet the original proposal that you made to the town? In other words, this plot plan and this parking area was under the original?
I think it was under the original. So, I mean, there's about approximately 10 feet here, and this spot is 20, and then that's 20, and that's 20. So it's approximately 70 feet.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. John?
Yeah. We proposed a fire station right in that ball field, and the setback from the building was 50 feet, not 70 feet. And I got two petitions here, one of 270 signatures, and it states as follows: we, the undersigned voter and resident of Hadley, petition the Board of Selectmen to submit this article for October 27, 2016 town meeting. Article to read as follows: shall the town of Hadley move to demolish?
That's not here. You got to give that to the selectmen.
This is reasons why the people want that hall demolished and build a fire station on that land. It's relevant to this case.
That's not germane to this.
Yes, it
period.
Is. Yes, it is. Because if you grant that, you can't do that. And what he's asking for is totally against the zoning bylaws. And I can talk, start far as I'm the chairman of the committee to build a fire station on that ball field. All right? And I have another petition with 234 signatures. We, the undersigned residents of Hadley, petition the Zoning Board of Appeal, that'll be you, and the Board of Selectmen to take the appropriate action to construct a North Hadley fire station on land presently owned by the town of Hadley, known as the North Hadley Hall Ball Field, or take any action thereto. So I want to give you this. This is 234 and it's 270.
We cannot take any action on that now. You can put it up here, but...
But this is relevant to your decision. You can't do both. And again, let me speak loud and clear. The zoning law prohibits apartments in this town. So what is Mr. Greenbaum's hardship to go in front of you folks for a variance? He has no hardship. And you have to grant us with a hardship. What kind of hardship is he gonna say to us? He has none.
I certainly don't have a hardship, John, but I mean
you can't do it.
The town voted to sell the building.
Not for apartments.
Well,
and you have,
that's why
you
we're
have
here today.
To show Mr. Greenbaum a hardship, which you can't, and you just admitted you don't have a hardship.
I think the hardship is that many people in the town of Hadley would like to see the building saved.
It's not a hardship.
Donald.
I just want a point of interest. When we're talking about apartments, there aren't any in this town presently. What transpired on Shady Line was a variance that was illegal. There was a double sword there, edged sword. The citizens that lived around there had a choice, either a rehab center or let the gentleman do apartments. They all requested, they didn't want the rehab center and allowed them to do the apartments because it was the lesser of the two evils. Our town allows us to build 55 and older housing. We have a bylaw for that. I would like to ask Mr. Greenbaum, why isn't he imposing 55 and older housing? I think that would go a lot better with the neighborhood, and I think it would please a lot more people than having apartments and younger age people there. 55 and older housing, you would probably have one car, less people in the building, and guaranteed no noise.
Well, you mentioned a double-edged sword, Donald, and the double-edged sword here is there's some residents here that want to keep it, and there's some people that would like to see it come down and entertain Mr. Michkowski's proposal for a fire station. Well, that's the double-edged sword. It's either going to be sold to somebody that will do something with it, or the town is going to be left to find somebody, some other developer for some other use, or it's going to have to be raised. So that's the double-edged sword we're talking about here.
Things have also changed. Initially, it was a 50 feet right away next to the building. Now he wants the whole lot. That takes away all of the parking that we were going to propose for the church safety to get them off of Route 47. And it also negates any access to Lake Warner for the future for a park. We just had the scenic byway thing at Huntington House proposed. Only one that there's funding for in the whole United States. It's a national byway. We could get funding for a park that would be an ideal place for it, you know, and along to get kayaks in and canoes. But once we give it to somebody private, we're gonna lose all access. They say, oh, you can put it in down near the dam, but we'll lose all access. Once it goes to private, the town has no more control over anything.
Jimmy?
Yeah, at a town meeting, when this was proposed to be sold, I was going to propose an amendment to the bylaw to be approved without variance. And it was voted down because they said, well, still, this is going to the Zoning Board of Appeals, and the Zoning Board of Appeals will have the common sense to make the right decision. I mean,
little do they know,
I wish it was not voted down, but that's the way it was. And, you know, it was voted down by enough, well, voted down, whatever, by majority or by one vote, it's irrelevant. The amendment didn't pass. And now it's in front of you, and you're going to make the hard decision to either grant the variance or not grant the variance. And, you know, there's already a fire station in North Hadley, so putting a new fire station 100 feet away from the existing fire station is by no means making the place less attractive in any way, shape, or form. It still would be right in the center, it would be a nice looking building. But if this is granted, it's going to make the fire potential fire station difficult thing, and like Mr. Pipchinski said. And to the point is, you know, two-family dwelling is allowed with a special permit. This is probably way too big for a two-family dwelling. He's proposing 10. Mr. Greenbaum has a history of doing a good job. I don't have any fault with that, but the fact is, there is no hardship to grant this variance.
If this is granted, okay, who's to stop the next one when the next building comes up? And the next one, and the next one, and the one after that?
Well, I can tell you that the ZBA has the authority to grant variances, and they have to be granted and
but
argued
no
on the basis of
here.
On their own merits.
But there's no hardship in this one, so if you grant this one, there's no hardship on the next one.
There's no slippery slope. In other words, just because one is granted today doesn't mean that every successive situation would be granted. Each one, as John said, has to be decided on the individual merits. So, you know.
It's not precedent setting just because one is granted.
Yes, sir. Can you state your name when you
write? I'll go right ahead.
Go ahead.
Stuart Beckley from the Congregational Church next door, 243 River Drive. So if I agree that it's not precedent setting, but could you, either the applicant or the board, go through your zoning bylaw and explain how this would meet the requirements of a variance? Because they're very specific both in the bylaw and in the state law of what's needed for a variance. And I don't see how this meets the four-step test.
Well, I mean, I think we haven't made a decision to try to grant the variance yet, so we haven't necessarily made all the findings that would
well,
be required.
Well, a couple of the things is that, as we brought out already, that, you know, you can't, you have to have hardship, which there really isn't any hardship here at this point, other than, you know, the idea of a development that would, at its completion, have four units in it. And then the other thing is, you know, how it affects the neighborhood. Does it, is it any more detrimental or less detrimental than what's existing there now? I guess the only detrimental part right now is that the building is not having as much use as it has in the past and is further deteriorating all the time.
May I ask a question?
Yeah, go ahead.
Have there been any other ideas for the piece of
I don't know, I've heard that to the Board of Selectmen. Has there been any other
at this point, no, but Mr. Michkowski's proposing a waiting period time on there or creating a committee and let it stay for two more years, and the fire department would still like to build out the front of that to move their new fire truck to North Hadley that doesn't fit in North Hadley now when we get the new one in a couple of weeks. So, and the fire chief says that could be accomplished for about $8,000, which we have $92,000 sitting in a Russell School account. That would buy us a long time till we could decide if the site isn't for a fire station in there, it could be put somewhere else, but we would buy the time, and then during that time, a committee could be created to find out if there is a viable use. The center school in Hatfield just did 55 and older housing, 8 units in there. And Mr. Greenbaum didn't answer my question. Why can't you do 55 and older housing?
I'm happy to answer your question.
Okay, I'd like to hear it.
So, first of all, let's talk about access to the pond. I'm very happy to work with the town to create access to the pond. It's never come up, but I'm happy to do so, whatever you'd like. Age 55 and over, let me explain. that building restoration is gonna cost $1.2 million. I don't want to, I want to be able, I'm not 100% sure I'd be able to rent the whole place to 55 and over. I just don't know the market, and I don't want to restrict myself like that.
55 and older housing would definitely kick into an elevator, right?
Yeah, I'm sure it would have,
and that's,
right?
And you know, that could be $350,000 alone on that one item.
I understand.
And so it would not be profitable to do 55 and older housing, you're saying?
Well, you just answered your own question.
Okay, but I wanted you to say that.
Thanks.
Carrie, you show 233 River Drive. My husband and I own the property that abuts North Hadley Hall. And I do agree with Mr. Greenbaum. He takes care of his properties. The tenants that he has and the current properties around us are respectable. My concern is, when we brought this to town meeting to have the people vote whether to sell it or not, they weren't under the understanding of the possibility of maybe 10 apartments going in there. They weren't under the understanding of the cost that the town is willing to sell it for. And so my question is, if you allow a variance before we put it up for sale, could we get more money for it other than what he is proposing? And I understand the cost of what you're going to put into it and make it look nice and so forth. But I'm looking at, well, can the town make more money if you grant the variance and then we put it out to bid again to see if somebody else could purchase it? Do I want a lot of cars there? No, absolutely not. But I also want to see what's best in the area that I live in and my children and grandchildren are going to be living in. And I don't think the town was informed enough. Mm-hmm. So I'm in favor of, maybe they do want to allow Mr. Greenbaum to do this, but I'm in favor, bring it back to the town meeting. Let the people be more aware of what possibly could be done with this building. I'm not against a fire station going in there. I actually like and feel comfortable knowing that there's one right next door.
I agree.
I think the town could do a lot of things with that property, even if we did put a fire station in there. There's no guarantee on anything. And I do understand that when you put 10 apartments in there, you can't guarantee who lives, you know, who's gonna live in there. My other issue is that if you do sell the property to Mr. Greenbaum or anybody else, you are giving up access to the lake. And people think that our property behind North Hadley Hall is town property, and it's not. And we forever have people going down there and trying, you know, to access the pond. And so I have an issue with that too. So if you sell it out of the town to a private owner, now that brings more of an issue for my husband and my family. So I'm looking at it that way as well. I think that you seriously need to look at this and really think about if you should allow the variance, and you're also setting a precedence for future people down the road.
I like your thoughts about taking it to town meeting. Yes.
I'm Margie Townsend. I live at 18 Mount Warner Road, and I just have a couple of things to read from the Historical Commission.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the building, and just like Donnie Pip said, Route 47, or our River Drive, has now been designated to quote them. The Connecticut River Scenic Byway is the only nationally designated byway in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. So it's not just one of the Massachusetts scenic byways, it's a nationally designated one. So that makes us kind of famous, okay? And this is the, if you haven't seen this, they did give them out at the opening of the National Scenic Byway. But this is from the state of Massachusetts about historic buildings. And I'll quote, "Within the village of North Hadley, the building is a prominent and distinctive presence in the streetscape with its size and well-preserved Italianate accents forming the building that accurately reflects its historic aesthetic and design." And
The cultural, historical, and architectural significance of the building emanates from its construction in 1864, its location as a contributing property within the North Hadley Historic District, designated December 30th, 1993, and is listed on the State and National Registrar of Historic Places. And that means the restriction is to assure that the exterior architectural, historic, cultural features of the building be retained and maintained forever substantially in their current condition for conservation and preservation purposes, and to prevent any change to the exterior of the building that will significantly impair or interfere with the building's preservation. And the building or any part thereof shall not be demolished, removed, or raised. Because it's within the historic district of North Hadley, it's on the scenic byway, it's a nationally designated building itself. So it puts it in a different classification. You can't just knock it down. You probably can, but it would probably take about 7 years. You'd have to go through all these things with the state. This was put in place for a while ago. And this draft from the state has been, it was given to the select board a long time ago.
Ben, do you take that to mean that the fire station building or part of that building would have to remain?
The building, the outline of the building as it stands has to remain. Just the footprint. You can do within it whatever you want to, like Mr. Greenbaum was going to make it into apartments.
Well, that sounds to me, Jen, I'm not sure you can help me with this.
No, Jimmy's going to answer that.
Well, I'm not quite sure what I answer, but to make it clear that the North Hadley Village, the center of town, and Hockenheim is listed on a National Register of Historic Places. There is no historic district in a town of Hadley. It has never passed, it has never been voted on. So I don't know where the state has come up with this thing about the building being sacred, if you would, because the town has never voted to accept that, so I would question the wording in that pamphlet.
Right.
Okay.
John?
Yeah, I talked to Gregory Farmer. He's in the historic consultant, and I delivered a letter to the Historic Commission. That building, as long as it didn't take federal or state funding, town meeting can vote to demolish that building. That's not true what they say, it can't. I delivered that letter to them that this gentleman sent me, I got through Bill Dwyer. And same thing with that building. That building stood there for 53 years supplying fire service. Our last town meeting rejected spending $500,000 for land that town already owns, the land up in further north, to build a fire station. Why would they spend money there when they have the land here? And again, that building, I got that documentation of it, and Bill Dwyer sent me this thing. And that's not true what the Historic Commission is saying, that it can't be knocked down, because it can.
I'm just relaying to you what we received from the state of Massachusetts.
Well.
Yes.
Jean Baxter, Stockwell Road. My concern is not as much with the building, and actually Mr. Greenbaum's proposal sounds very attractive. My concern is with the open area, the field, and I was disheartened that the town had included the entire parcel with the offer, with the proposal. I would certainly be more in favor of a proposal like Mr. Greenbaum's if the proposal recommended that the town retain a certain portion of the land, or that the proposal included designating a certain area of the land to be recreational space, support for the church, and town access to the pond. Those, the preservation of the field for, or of any of the thing for community support would make a big difference in how I felt about the whole project. If you had said, oh, I'm gonna make the whole first floor open for community recreation, and I'm just gonna make apartments upstairs, I think the reaction would be very different. I think if you could say the outside is gonna be open to the community in this way, that would make us feel better.
So that was one of the options that I ran through my head, you know, as, you know, what could this building be good for? How can it benefit the community? And the original draft did have a community room. But then I was saying, well, how are the two gonna mix together? If you're having Zumba downstairs and people are trying to sleep upstairs. And like I said, that's why I just went to what I know, okay? Now, I'm very happy to dedicate the balance of the ball field to whatever the town would like, you know? I don't need
it. Could we do that formally?
Of course. I mean, I would like to own it, but...
How about not owning it?
Well, I think we should. So, but anyway, that's where I'm going with my...
There can
I'd
be
like
conditions. That's what the ZBA does. They put conditions on special
yeah,
permits. So yeah, I'm fine with that.
So, I never mentioned where I live, but I live on River Drive 267. This meeting's about zoning, correct?
Mm-hmm.
We haven't really talked much about zoning. What we've talked about, like my friend neighbor here shared, is ideas of what to do with the space. It seems to me we're all still at that first phase. We're not ready to give it up to be apartments, and I have no doubt in my mind that Mr. Greenbaum wouldn't make it look beautiful. I'm sure it would look nice. But I think there's still a lot of people out there with a lot of different ideas on how to incorporate this into the community, whether it be a fire station, whether it stays a rec hall, and we form a committee and take 2 years to see what kind of maybe can turn into something for our children, a playground, something like that. It seems like that's where we're at. Doesn't seem like we're at zoning. I think we're at what can we do with this land still? And I think bringing it back to a town meeting, I've lived there for 6 years now. We just built our home. And we've never heard of a mention of a town meeting discussing the fate of this historic place.
Well, it came before town meeting.
At town meeting, right.
It was voted by town meeting to sell it.
Yeah, okay. But no, what I'm saying is that, okay, that's fine and well, but unfortunately, I guess we just weren't paying attention, raising our two children, being busy, but we didn't really hear about it.
Yeah.
And I really, truly think there's a lot of people that care about it. I know other families who couldn't be there tonight because they have young children. I know that I'm going to be sort of reporting back to them, so to speak. And I think that the fate of the area is still something to debate and talk about.
Tim?
So, I'm Tim Neihardt. I'm the building commissioner of town. I'm also on the municipal building committee. We have two other members here on the municipal building committee. Mm-hmm. And our whole requirement from the directive from the select board is to figure out what to do with all of our municipal buildings, not just
yeah.
North Hadley Hall. That was the first purview. That's the first building that we looked at. And that started well over 2.5 years ago. We had a lot of public, we did have public hearings mm-hmm. in the building itself. The dilemma that we're in is we would all love to be able to fix up the building. Our dilemma is we're a municipality. When it comes to fixing up buildings, when it comes to doing anything, we're under prevailing wage. Mr. Greenbaum just stated for him to do what he wants to do on that entire building would cost him $1.2 million. For us to just rehab it and not change the building, but just get it maintained is over $3 million. And that's not you know, setting it up for any department. Our problem is that if we do something as a municipality, we are required by state statute to make it accessible. That first floor, being as tall as it is,
mm-hmm.
it creates a huge, huge issue. The 55 and older creates an issue with accessibility. Now, when one comes in, and we've advertised it, and the hope was that we would get multiple requests on utilizing that building. Unfortunately, we didn't.
one of the things that we have to also realize is the amount of money that it's going to cost to fix it up. And the unique thing about the apartments is he doesn't have to put that elevator in. He doesn't have to make it accessible by state's code. Should he? Yeah, but he doesn't have to. So we can only require him to do what code says. So what do we do with the building? You know, throwing $3 million into a building that we don't have a purpose for other than a community space or something. But again, we don't, that's $3 million is just to fix up the problems associated with the building now. It doesn't go any further than that. So we're putting huge amounts of money into it, okay? We would all like to keep it. I don't want to, my own thing is, I do not want to see that building come down. I like the look of it. This gentleman has come forward and said he will fix it up under the historical preservation laws, and it will look like it's supposed to. We're not, we certainly as a town haven't done due diligence for that place. And it's unfortunate, you know? And John's proposal is, you know, if we don't do some, allow somebody to use that building, the building's coming down and John's, and the fire station goes there. There's not much else we can do with the building. That's the unfortunate problem. And one thing, if I may, the one question that was not answered was about variances. What are permitted by variances? It's very specific on what, how variances can be granted. And it has to do with topography of land and shape. It also says shape of a structure. Shape of a structure is also the size of a structure. So when we look at the size of a structure, what can you do with that building based on its size, its uniqueness? And that is something that this ZBA has to grapple with. The idea that we can give a special permit to make it a two-family is not true. And the reason is because when you read it specifically, it says conversion from a one-family to a two-family is permitted by a special permit. The only thing other that is in our bylaw is a 55 and older. But then you, just like Mr. Paczynski said, you're adding those very, very expensive add-ons, i.e. the elevator, that would create a price tag that would actually create a problem of trying to get your money back in a specific thing. So it is a big problem for us.
Well, and I understand.
Excuse me, but she had her thing.
Oh, sure. Yes.
You, by all means, finish your thought.
Thank you. I see how Mr. Greenbaum would, again, beautify it, restore it. The problem is, I guess, and it's no offense to you, sir, honestly, it's letting the town, letting it go. And then after Mr. Greenbaum, then who's what kind of housing is it going to turn into?
It's that variance stays with the property forever. It cannot change.
So you're saying that the covenant says if you had
all
covenants this, all
and
the covenant
everything
is transferred
associated with
any,
it.
Any
yeah.
other owner.
Now you're giving a variance for this. How do I know they're not going to give a, you know, is that how it works?
Well, the variance would be transferred from Mr. Greenbaum to a potentially new owner if he decided to do it. Yes, ma'am.
Thank That's you. Why we have these hearings, so you can come to the next variance and your argument, just like you're doing now.
Thank you. I have been a resident of North Hadley for the last 18 years. I live directly across the street from the town hall and the church. One of the things that attracted me into the purchase of my house was the quietness of the farmland area. With all due respect to Mr. Greenbaum, he used the word never regarding problems with the house on Meadow Street. That's not true.
I didn't talk about Meadow Street.
Yes, you did.
You already talked about the corner.
You mean on the corner of Meadow Street?
Yeah.
The corner of Meadow Street.
Oh, 240
exactly.
River Drive?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Sorry.
Sorry for not being more clear on that. The police were summoned there last September. Now, it's not a frequent situation, but there was a noise element that took place last September where the police were there at 11 o'clock at night, okay? Last Tuesday, an article appeared in the Gazette that indicated 1,000 people showed up at a party in Amherst where the police were pelted with bottles. You read that article at least twice a year for the last 4 years, okay? I would hate to see that happen to the Hadley police. Now, Mr. Greenbaum says he can't guarantee anything. So how are we to be sure that these apartments are only going to go to graduate students and not undergraduate students when there is no guarantee? All you need is one email to go out and 1,000 people show up for a party. I would hate to have my life disrupted by this kind of behavior. And if that's my concern. Someone here brought up the situation of parking the last time. And Mr. Greenbaum didn't realize that people were not parking in the parking that was provided at the house that, what's the street number again? On Meadow?
On
the corner of Meadow. Well, last Saturday, two cars, a truck and a black car with Connecticut plates, was there all night Saturday night from that house.
It was parents helping their kids move in. I know that.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Okay, well, why were they there at 10 o'clock when people were going to church and couldn't park close to the door of the church?
I don't know.
Okay, sorry. But this is, nothing is guaranteed, you're right. But it is a concern of mine and other people that live in this town. And we're there every day and we can see what happens. And I just wanted you all to know that. Thank you for your time.
Terry?
So this is kind of towards to Mr. Neihardt. You state how much it would cost the town to fix it versus a private owner. You don't mention how much it might cost the town to knock it down. So when you're up there and you're trying to convince all of us of the town can't afford this, are you speaking using your position to try to sell that to all of us to favor Mr. Greenbaum? Or
my position on the municipal building committee.
Okay, so
because we reviewed all the
when
numbers.
All okay, that's fine. But when all of this was decided to sell it and no price was ever set on the building and it went to town meeting, nobody knew any of this. That you didn't stand up and I don't think run those numbers by and say the town can't afford this, somebody privately can own it. And then who so it kind of looks like you're in favor and you're trying to push in people here in favor of Mr. Greenbaum, and I kind of think that's how I'm taking it. I don't know how anybody else is taking it. And so
if I could, I think Tim was speaking to several members of the audience here who had said that they would like love to see the building preserved and see the town maintain ownership of the building.
Yeah, but he's mentioning numbers, and it's town can't afford it.
Well,
town should have thought about 100 years ago.
What Tim is addressing is that this committee that he's on has evaluated whether the town could continue to own the property, and that's what Tim is speaking to. He's not speaking to demolishing it. He's addressing people who are saying that.
Well, if he's going
like to
mention numbers, and he's speaking on the behalf of this committee, and he's also the building inspector, he should list all the funds, all the numbers, like. How much is it going to cost to demolish the building?
They're all there.
So how much will it cost the town to demolish that building?
$60,000.
Do you agree with that?
I think it's on the low side, but
$60,000 plus asbestos removal.
Plus the asbestos removal.
So we can demolish the building and still maintain the property.
Yeah, she can tell you that it's pretty expensive.
Trust me. I just demolished the house on the S-curve. I'm at 211 River Drive, the teeny tiny 700 foot empty fluorescent yellow house. Everybody knows where it was.
Kind of missed that.
Let me tell you, it was a landmark. All I had to do when people asked me where I lived was say the fluorescent yellow house, and they all knew what it was. That tiny house costs nearly $30,000 to demolish, so 60 is a very low estimate. If that tiny house costs nearly 30 to take down, that big hall would take a lot more than 60.
John?
This young lady had her hand up.
So a couple things. I was at one of the meetings a couple years ago when we had it actually in the hall, and the numbers being thrown around were, you know, to purchase the value of that land, the building, those numbers being tossed around were like between $300,000 and $400,000. There was an article in the paper just 2 weeks ago that we need a new senior center, and we're looking, you know, that's a very costly thing. We're looking for land to build a new senior center. We also need the new fire station. So there's all these things that the town and the town's people need. And from what I'm hearing, the price that is being offered for the hall is something near $72,000. That piece doesn't make sense to me.
100.
So there's things that the town needs that will benefit the town, whether it be another fire station or a senior center.
Yeah.
The town already owns that land, and rather than give up that land for that small amount of money and turn it into apartments, that's one side of it. The other side is that I'm a direct abutter, and then until today I hadn't seen this picture. There's going to be people within 2 feet of me on a patio.
I couldn't,
you know,
hear
I just saw the picture today. There's going to be a patio within 2 feet of me. I don't think that amount of people coming in with that amount of apartments is going to preserve the integrity of our neighborhood. It's largely owner occupied, the apartments that are there. It's small, it's quiet. This would bring in 20 more cars and that much more traffic. I just think that there's other options, and I totally agree with Terry's suggestion of let the people of the town know that you're gonna be giving up this valuable piece of property, this historic piece of property, for that small amount of money to turn it into apartments that they don't fit. It doesn't fit into that area. We already have enough there. We want apartments. Look for land on Route 9 where there's already people in traffic, and I for one would like to preserve the peacefulness of that neighborhood by not bringing in 10 more apartments that I just don't feel we need.
John?
Yeah, Selectman Joyce Jungle asked me so I could do some research on if the town, and she's in favor of demolishing the North Hadley Hall. Associated Records did send out a estimate of $60,000, and it was, I think, $12,000 to abate the asbestos, not removal, and that took care of taking all the debris out, but not filling in the cellar hole.
It was $12,000 to take the asbestos out of that tiny house next door to me.
Well, I'm not arguing that.
So,
this
me,
project overall
price.
Is probably $125,000 total.
Well, let's not talk about raising the building, because I'm sure
no,
from the conversation that
out.
We've had here today, most of these people want to preserve that building in some shape,
you know,
or manner, but they don't want to have apartments there. That's
right.
The sense I'm
right.
getting.
I do have another question about the parking. I am concerned. What was the number you're proposing at this point for spaces?
15, he's proposing.
15. And it's 10 units? I think you're right that people do own
two cars.
More than one car. You can't be certain that it would be a single person living in the studios. It could be a couple living in studios if they're graduate students. And you have visitors. You have the weekend, and mom's going to come over. Your grad student mom and dad are coming for the weekend. You're going to have a holiday. You've got a one-bedroom apartment, and the sister's coming in. So you're adding people to that, especially on the weekends. And as it is, the North Hadley Congregational Church, I happen to belong to, doesn't have enough parking. And if some of that street is going to be, one, parking for your building, and two, turned into grass area, we have even less places to put cars.
This parking lot can easily be 20. We put trees here to screen these spots from the road, but these could be, you know, five more spots with screening along the road.
Yep. My concern is, where do the cars for North Hadley park?
I don't know.
I made that observation just yesterday. You had a dinner or something there.
That, because right now, we park all the way down in front of the town, the village hall.
Yeah,
we park all the way down into there, and we have barbecues and concerts.
Well, so what are you proposing then, that we work on something together, or are you saying?
Well, I mean, you know, I mean, first of all, I mean, my instinct is, I agree, I would like this to remain a quiet neighborhood. 10 apartments, I think, is too much. I kind of get that, not sure what the town can do with it, given the cost of redoing things, but I think it needs to be revisited. You know, if we need a fire station, why aren't we turning that into revamping what fire station is there? If we need a center, why aren't we revamping that to put the senior center there? What's gonna be the cost of a new senior center, a new fire department, et cetera, versus making something out of what we have there?
It's always cheaper to build new than to renovate old, these old type of buildings. It always is. That's a dilemma.
Edward?
But I, if it ends up going this way, if it can't be rehashed and find a way to use it for public use, if it is too expensive and we have to have some kind of proposal accepted, I would say less apartments. But would you be willing to work with the North Hadley Congregational Church and the town on access to the pond, on parking for the church? Would you be willing to partner with people to discuss that further?
Of course. My question is, though, well, I guess we could talk about this later, but how would we, you're talking about creating more parking. I assume that's what you're
talking about. Yeah, and also I think a lot of people would want access to the pond.
Access to the pond
is
no problem.
Okay.
Go for it.
Because I don't know how far that property goes
back. But my second question is, if you're creating more parking, then you're losing open space,
right.
Aren't you?
It would need some thought.
Mr. DeKevitz.
Yeah, if you grant this variance, what happens to the fire station? It's there now and it has no place to go. What happens to that?
Well, personally, and I haven't discussed this or brought this up, but I would request Mr. Greenbaum to give the town some time to relocate, because, I mean, if he said, you know, in 21 days he's going to start construction, the town is pretty much hanging out there with our fire trucks.
Yeah, I'm okay with that. The building, there's nothing going to be happening in the building all winter because the architect has to draw up the plans.
Go
ahead. Jean Baxter, Stockwell Road. Just a quickie. I heard that we consider the 55 and older apartments, and I'm wondering if it's possible to have it mixed and have the first floor be 55 and older. If the elevator is, I don't know what the dividing concerns are.
Mike?
So I'll just throw that out there as a proposal to you.
Mike Banish, 261 River Drive. I rented in a 6-unit building in South Deerfield going back a few years ago. It was all working people. The landlord let two grad student ladies move in up to the third floor. Well, I hear clunkety clunk clunk one night, and I look as the keg of beer is going up the stairs. Well, you would not believe how many people those two ladies, grad students, attracted to that building. It was absolutely incredible. No place on Friday through Sunday to park because it was full of people, beer cups all over the lawn, everything. It was a disaster. The landlord evicted them. He got in some more grad students. Same thing happened again. He evicted them. They got back into working people in there. No more problems. Grad students bring in parties. That's what I saw when I lived there. And I'm like, I think North Hadley Hall should not be.
I'm not saying that it's going to be housing for grad students. I said the building across the street has had grad students, and they were nurses, and they were fine.
Jason Goodine, 5 Meadow Street again. I came here with one thought in mind, and after hearing Mr. Greenbaum, I don't know what to think. I want to see the building. I don't want to see the building. I want a fire station. I don't want a fire. I don't know what to think. But what I do know is this has come up at town meetings. We've all had the opportunity to be at the town meeting, have our voice there. We're here about a variance. I've been at the town meetings. No one shows up. We've all had the opportunity to purchase. We all still have the opportunity to purchase the building. Every one of us. He's the only one willing to preserve it. I don't know what to think.
Jimmy?
The, Jim Maxmaski, 12 Norwood Drive. The, there's been so many ideas thrown out tonight that you couldn't possibly put enough conditions on this tonight to satisfy the variance if you grant it. It would be, it'll take you 2 hours to recite, to try to get them all together. That's just my two cents on the whole deal tonight. A lot of good ideas. Not gonna dispute that. But, you know, do this, give up more park, give access, give this. I don't know how you could even word that into the conditions to make it viable.
Yeah. I mean, personally, I get the sense that the majority of the people that are here are against having 10 apartments there. I don't know if they'd be happy with a lesser number. Mr. Greenbaum says it's not economically feasible for him to do it with less. And you're looking at three board members up here that are faced with making a decision on whether to grant him or turn him down. I liked Mrs. Yushko's idea of turning it to the town meeting and letting them decide what to do with it, because I certainly like that building. I mean, I grew up in North Hadley. I was a member of the fire department and went to a lot of functions at that hall. I don't want to see that hall disappear or be razed, but at the same time, the town has to do something with it to maintain its structural integrity. And how do we accomplish that? You know, us as a zoning board doesn't have the access to finances and what's in the budget for keeping that building standing. So I, as it stands now, I can't see 10 apartments there myself. Mr. Miskell.
Yeah. You know, I'm sure everybody likes to throw stuff in front of the town meeting, but we elect town officials, we appoint folks like you that are volunteers that serve a zoning board of appeals that under state statute, no one, the town meeting can't vote for it, the planning board can't vote for it, the board of selectmen. It is in your lap and it's in your responsibility under state statute that either you grant it or not grant it. And it's, you know, people don't go, this young gentleman says they don't go to town meeting. Well, shame on them. That's where it happens. That's our town government. If you're not there, sorry about it. We're going to move to the next page. And that's what I'm saying about it. You know, I know sometimes it's a tough, I serve on that planning board, and there's sometimes, you know, people are mad at you for voting, but do the right thing for the town, and that's it. That's the bottom line. You do what's right for the town.
Just a comment on what you said, John. I agree with you. Been on a planning board, obviously, for a long time. And early on, we were planning board was faced with a decision, and God bless Mr. Joe Weinsick, the one that had the excavating business, not his father, Joe. And he was on the opposite side of what was against the planning board. And I said, boy, I wish we could bring this to town meeting. And Mr. Weinsick stood up. He says, young man, he says, you've been elected to do your job. He says, you're the only ones that can do this. He says, it's a tough job. If you can't take the heat, you probably shouldn't be there. But he says, you know, you've got to make a decision one way or another. He says, I'm either going to win or lose in this deal. He says, but that is what your decision is. And, you know, I'm not trying to pick on you, but the zoning board in this particular case, short of rezoning the area, because you can't rezone for Mr. Greenbaum, that spot zoning, that's illegal. You could rezone it for municipal use, but that's a whole other different story. But you'd have to rezone most of North Hadley Center to allow this to be a legal use by right. Obviously, that probably wouldn't pass very well. but to grant the variance, that only group in town or city in the state that can do it is the Zoning Board of Appeals. And yeah, there's some pressure on you. No question about that.
I'd like to add something, well, not add, but I'd like to say something. There have been a lot of wonderful ideas here. And the problem I have with a lot of the ideas is that they're opposing, you know, there's a lot of opposing ideas. Hard to sort them out, hard to put all those restrictions. When it comes down to it, people vote their pocketbooks. And I don't think a lot would get done if you had to pay out $1.2 million to redo that building or more. And that's a concern that I'm thinking about my taxes. So I ask you to think about your taxes.
Don Kopczynski, 234 River Drive, North Hadley. I've lived there across the street from this hall 63 of my 67 years. I went to school there. I went to church there. I went to Boy Scouts there. I had our baby showers there. All kinds of things. We had campaign things. That hall, what everybody's talking about in here is sentimental value, which the town cannot afford anymore. We're having the park and rec move out of there, coming to Hooker School within the next month. The reasoning for that is we want to save the $20,000 a year for heating bills and maintenance in that building. The fire station can still exist there because they have their own heating system, so the main building can be shut down. I don't want to see the building torn down either, but the town, as Mr. Neihardt said, cannot afford to fix it with prevailing wage. We just can't. And town meeting has a vote out there right now, and Mrs. Chungalo, the selectman, is very adamant about taking that building down. She said it numerous times. I would still like to have a committee to give it the last hurrah. If they can't find anything to do with it, then let's take it down. And then the land it sits down can become passive land, and we'll still have access to the lake. And at the same time, we possibly can build a fire station there and save $500,000 of land expenses we don't have to spend up the street somewhere. And the church can have their off-street parking at the same time in a safe environment to park their cars. And as the young lady said, initially he came to us and the deal was $40,000. So now he ups it to $60,000, but he wants the whole ball of wax, leaving the town with nothing. And once he owns it, he sets his own direction. The town has no say in that property once he owns it. Secondly, this agreement was negotiated by two selectmen out of a board of five. This agreement still has to come back, even if he got the agreement for the variance. He does not have a buy and sell agreement. And a full board of five have to vote on this. The full board could vote 3-1, and somebody abstains, we don't know. So that is still up in the air also. So we have a lot of intangibles before you tonight, the zoning board, and I don't think you should make it hastily, believe me.
This is the truth.
Is it true that he does not have a buy and sell agreement?
I don't know. I'm not on the board of selectmen.
Yeah, it's true, Bob.
There's no buy and sell.
So how can we give him a variance on something he doesn't own?
The selectmen allows it. As the owners of the property. They agree.
Jack, you haven't said anything all night.
I'm from the old folk home. In other words, you want canoes to go down there? You ain't gonna have canoes go down. Go down there now and take a look at it. Nothing but mud. That deep. And it's gonna be like that after they fix that dam. You know why? The water ain't gonna stay there. Because you got too many damn weeds there. We proposed that 5 years ago to drain that pond and let it stay for 2 years. That would kill everything. But no, this is what we got. About 3 feet of mud now. And it's gonna stay there. In other words, the town's gonna redo the pond? No. That's gonna cost millions of dollars.
Right.
And you ain't gonna get canoes down here. Let me tell you, the bank is almost 20 feet. Where are you gonna dig a trench down there?
Sure.
You're gonna have to start from the road to make a trench. That's the way it is.
Ms. Townsend?
Didn't the town pass the sale of North Hadley Hall at the last town meeting?
They
Was
voted,
they voted to sell it?
To sell it, yeah.
Okay. Is there enough confusion just to bring it back to town meeting and ask, do you want to change your mind, townspeople? Do you not want to sell it now? Or something else? I don't know, that's just an idea. It seems like there are so, and to sell it to Mr. Greenbaum for his plan or tear it down are just two options. That doesn't mean there are only two options. Perhaps we should revisit it. Take it back to the town and say, many people did not understand that this was this building we're talking about and that the town wants to sell it because they don't have any money. You know, make it maybe a little clearer, maybe revisit the whole idea.
Okay, I got two more over here and then I'm gonna...
So for the purpose of this meeting right here, right now,
mm-hmm.
is whether or not to grant a variance.
Yeah.
Right.
If you grant a variance, you can't take it back. And with this much opposition, I don't know if you would feel comfortable making that decision to grant that variance, you can't take it back.
Observe it.
He's Ed DeKevitz, 10 Meadow Street. Time to stop kicking a can down the road. Because, you know, one person says, let's bring it back to town meeting. It's going to be a continuous circle.
Right.
Make the decision here.
Yes.
Cheryl Cruddis, 27 Meadow Street. The only thing I haven't seen dealt with so far is the fire department. And I don't understand if you did grant him a variance and he did start building, how are you going to handle this relocation of the fire department? Is
well,
that a priority?
Well, that would be up to the selectmen to handle that. But
we have to make this decision first.
We,
Well, not really.
We'll put it on Stockholm Road.
Yeah.
How's that?
Okay.
I mean, it's there now and it's going to have to move.
I just leave you with one thing. I know I haven't been to the town meetings. I'm new in town. I'm just sort of getting into this, and I'm not even from Western Massachusetts, but I care about the neighborhood I live in, and I care about Hadley. I care about North Hadley. A lot of us have already, we've gone through childhood. We've grown up in safe places. I'm listening to everybody talk about how wonderful their childhood was, how wonderful North Hadley is, has been, will be, its potential. Think about children. Think about our future. Think about what is going to be the best for our community. I understand the math, I understand the figures, and maybe it won't be possible. But let's get the word out there. I say we bring it back to a town meeting, and I'm sorry to maybe reinvent the wheel here a little bit.
It is good to be invented.
Then I leave you with maybe not putting it in, making it apartments. You know what? I think I care more about my children, the future, the quietness of the neighborhood, the what it represents. Listening to all, I've only lived there for 5 years. Listening to all of you talk, you've lived there your entire lives. What it can be and what it could unfortunately turn into. And I think I would honestly, at this point, if it's not going to be reintroduced at a town meeting, I'm all for saving buildings and the historical sites. But if having a fire station rather than 20 apartments, I'm gonna take it. Because that is gonna make my community safer. It's gonna, it's nice knowing that someday if Mr. Greenbaum, if it's sold or if it turns into something else, at least I know it's a safe place. It's somewhere where my children are not gonna fear to go, or loud music, or, you know, at least it's for the community. And I hate to say that, and I hate to see a building taken down, but if those are my options, then that's what I'd rather see.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, earlier someone said the North Hadley Hall was the anchor of the village, and I think I see the land next to it really is the anchor, and you know,
well,
so,
mm-hmm.
yeah, so I don't think you can, really, because I was here at the last meeting, squeeze in the fire department and turn this building into a 10-unit apartment. So I agree with what a few people have said. I think you have to do one or the other. If you try to get both in there, it is going to, I think, ruin the entire integrity of the village. And
So I'd rather see the building taken down and put a fire department there if that's what it's going to take to save money. But so that might mean going back to town meeting if that's sort of the direction.
Okay, last question over here.
Just a point of interest for myself. Say if the variance is turned down this evening, do you still have any interest in the building, Mr. Greenbaum, if your variance is turned down?
No.
Thank you.
Okay, John.
Okay.
I kind of think that we're going back and forth, that we postponed it once before for the selectmen to act on it. The selectmen kind of sent it back to us.
Yeah.
There's kind of two
things.
Can
we send it to the planning board?
Only if you approve for site plan approval.
I hear what everyone is saying, but I mean, Mr. Greenbaum's not trying to steal the property. The selectmen are trying to sell it to him.
Yeah.
So a lot of the decisions about what to do with the property have already been made. The selectmen are like trying to sell the property. So it seems like a little bit late to be talking about a lot of these other things about going back to the town meeting, but.
Exactly. I can't see 10 apartments myself.
Just a quick question. When this, you say the selectmen are trying to sell it to him, when you originally went to them, was it just for a piece of it and not the whole thing?
So my original offer was for $75,000, and I had left off a strip that the town wanted to access the pond.
Okay.
Which I was fine with that.
Mm-hmm.
And then the more I thought about it, then my second plan was, I had started hearing things about a fire substation. And I said, okay, if that's what the town wants, I can work with that. But then they started telling me, no, we need more land, more land, more land. All of a sudden, we had this 150-foot rectangle that gave me no parking, and it turned the whole ball field into a building in blacktop, which would have looked horrible. So it was at that point where I put in a new offer for $100,000 for the whole thing. Because the building should be with the land. And, you know, I sit here and I understand everyone's dilemma. And quite honestly, half of me just wants to back out. Okay? Because I want to save the building. It's a beautiful building. And I could make it look really nice. But if the town doesn't want it, what am I fighting for? I'm not going to go up against you guys, you know? I love North Hadley, too. So, I mean, you guys decide. I can walk. It's no problem. I got plenty of work to do with three kids.
So, I have a question for you. If the town, decided, you decided that you weren't going to purchase it, would you support a town putting a fire station, some fire station there?
No, I would not support that. It should be further up north and not in the village.
Okay, we're going to move the question then.
I move that we grant the variance to Mr. Joel Greenbaum for more residential units, specifically 10, than are allowed by the zoning bylaws.
No.
Obviously, you don't listen.
I so move.
When you came to the meeting in the beginning.
Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
I'm nay on that.
What do you say?
Nay.
No.
Game over.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
Thank you.
No, you moved the question the way it was written on the application. Yeah, you did right.
John.
prior to leaving, can you explain why the second hearing is being with the fire station for everyone here? Because a lot of people are paying for that.
Hold on, let me tell you. Put two and two together.
This is difficult.
Don't go anywhere. You have a request for continuance on your property. We're going to take that up. It may be a while. Yeah. No, you are. Yeah, but it has to come before our board.
Not tonight, Jeff.
Well, we got another one here yet.
There was used to be a third.
No, we don't.
So this has been well, this has been canceled anyway.
And so
Donald.
I'll send you another email. So you will,
did you see the letter?
No, I haven't. That's why I'm asking the White House to reach out.
Yeah. Okay. The second part of the hearing was the Town of Hadley petition for a variance on 239 River Drive, and it's been a request by the Board of Selectmen for continuance. And I'll read the letter.
Can I ask when that vote was taken? I was never part of it or never asked to be part of it.
Where did this happen?
Well, the letter came from David Nixon.
How could he do that?
I have
no
idea.
There was no public meeting. He's a selectman.
Selectman, I wasn't even notified. He said the Board of Selectmen voted.
Well, it comes from the town administrator, okay?
Hey, you can't do that again. You
what is
it? You pushed it back to them. They kicked it back to you, and you're, what is this? Ping pong? You gotta stop this, make a decision.
Okay,
we just
will
did.
You just, will you just sit down?
Jeez.
It is my understanding that the town's petition was filed with the Zoning Board of Appeals on July 14, 2016, and that the 100-day period for which a decision by the Zoning Board of Appeals must be given expires on October 4th. The board has a meeting scheduled for September 19th, but the town's petition is not listed on the agenda. In order to give the parties an equal opportunity to be heard and the present information, I request a continuance of the hearing on this particular matter. And it's signed David Nixon, town administrator.
John, I don't understand that because your board voted to extend both hearings till tonight.
Yep.
And how did it get changed in between if your board didn't vote on it?
He's requesting it. We don't have to accept it.
Yeah.
So.
What was the notice, though? That one wasn't on the notice.
No, I'm saying the last time we met, you extended both hearings
yes,
until tonight.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, the second hearing gets canceled without anybody's notification.
Wait a minute, Donald.
You know, it's a continuance.
What was on the original post? The original posting. What was the original posting when you first...
Request by the Hadley Fire Substation Committee,
yeah,
which is under the authority of the Board of Selectmen,
right,
to divide North Hadley Hall, 239 River Drive, map 68, lot 29, into two non-conforming lots. One portion of the lot will continue the North Hadley Hall, which will be sold, while the other lot will be kept for municipal uses.
Would you still be looking?
There was supposed to be a setback.
Would you still
there's
be
nothing nothing there about setback.
Would we even be still to sub? Would we still even be ruling on that? Or
I mean, there's no. We don't have to do this now because
yes,
the first part has been just the apartments have been voted down.
That's fine.
Okay.
That's right. It goes back to one lot.
Right.
One original lot.
But
why would you want a second here?
Wait a minute.
Two lots?
Because of the setback.
There's nothing in here about setback.
It was about splitting it.
It was about splitting it. That's all it was.
you filled that out, and right here is the map.
I'm going home.
John, this hasn't changed from day one.
But it's not on this thing here.
Well, who set that? Who set that agenda? Here's the setback.
34 feet on this, 31, 33 feet from the property line. Who set that?
I don't know.
Who did that?
I did, but you did not have anything specific relative. The issue was splitting the lot. The other stuff is irrelevant. It can be done at any time. If you need the 45 feet, that can be granted at any time.
Anytime. You know what the problem is? You're supposed to be representing the town of Hadley, and you're getting too involved with people coming into your office.
Wait a minute, Donald, I want to listen to what you say.
That is true.
Town council, I had a discussion with him today. He says that the setback that will, it can be. The town council said that we can vote the setback at any point in time that's necessary to accomplish what you want to do.
That's a finding, right?
Right.
That's not a variance, it's a finding.
Oh.
The setback.
No, I think it would be a variance, but it doesn't have to be done now. This can even go to town meeting. Your fire station can go to town meeting without the setback, and that setback can be changed whenever it needs to be.
Because it's now it's the whole lot.
Right.
Okay.
All right?
All right. I was just hoping it wasn't kicked back in the selectmen.
No.
You know, because they can't make a decision there, and it comes back and forth, back and forth.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Acceptable. Sounds good. Thank you.
Okay. Now, one other piece of business here.
Oh, wait a minute.
Wait, Mr. Uscio. We've got. I can't find it now.
I'm only kidding,
John. He's only kidding. All right, thank you, guys.
Oh, well, we can do this anyway. This young lady wants a continuance for her property at. Was it?
209 River Drive.
209 River Drive.
Where the little fluorescent yellow house came down.
Yeah. Right. She has.
There's a grandfather closet. Says we have the right to build on it within 2 years.
Okay.
I've had a number of family issues, two elderly parents. My mother became partially paralyzed this year. My mother-in-law went into heart failure. We've had a number of family issues that have taken up my time. I'm the primary caregiver, and I haven't had time to go through conservation and zoning.
How much time do you need?
We'd like a 9-month extension.
All right. Is that all right with you?
Yeah.
Okay.
We may not even need that much, but we just, for that window, it's
so
taken up so much time to deal with the family. I haven't had time to meet with our family.
Is this something we already ruled on?
Yes.
Before me?
Yeah. That was taken down that house, the bright yellow house.
The one that looked like this.
Yeah, I know that. I'm just, do I need to write anything up on this? Is this just an informal?
No, just that we extended.
Do we need to do an opinion?
I would like a letter saying you have another 9 months on top of the 2 years.
So yeah.
Why wouldn't you grant it?
Yeah.
She's not causing anybody a hardship.
Yeah.
She's not causing anybody a hardship
right.
by asking.
Did we give you a variance?
No, she by her taking that building down, she has 2 years to put something back in its place.
But I need 2 years, 9 months, because the last 9 months I've spent giving caregiver to two elderly people. I haven't had time to apply to conservation, apply to zoning for a finding. I haven't had time to go through all the paperwork that I need to get it done.
What do we extend? Did we give them that?
That's standard.
It's a standard 2 year period. Okay. We have to rebuild on a non-conforming lot.
Yeah.
So
we're extending it beyond the standard 2 years.
Yeah.
Steve, I think you should paint part of your fence
bright
yellow.
Bright yellow in memorial.
It's the fluorescent yellow memorial fence.
Do you know I kept one of the clapboards?
Did you?
The
fluorescent yellow.
Room to build on that lot? I mean, I looked and I went, my God, that thing was ready to fall over.
The back foundation wall would be retaining style foundation wall so that it would.